Duck is very proud of being Great Western. He loves his job and makes sure all the trains run on time. He sometimes shunts at the big station when there is too many trains. But you will mostly find him on his branch line where he runs trains days and nights. One day, Duck was waiting with his branch line train at the junction when Thomas showed up.
"Sorry I'm late, Duck," panted Thomas.
"You've been late 3 times this week," Duck said crossly. "What's the hold-up?" "Oh no, wait, don't tell me. You've left the guard behind again and had to go back and get him." Before Thomas could answer, Duck steamed away.
"Hurry up, hurry up," he fussed to the coaches. "We mustn't lose time. Thomas has done too much of that already."
He puffed out of sight and left Thomas fuming. Duck soon arrived at Callan Station, where Oliver was waiting with his post train. "Thomas again?" chortled Oliver. "Ah well," he continued before Duck could answer, "we all make mistakes sometimes, and sometimes it's not even our fault." Duck thought about Oliver's words and hurried off to get his next train. As soon as Duck had got his new train ready, he got onto the front and waited to start. He waited and waited. "Peep, peep! What's happened to the guard?" asked Duck impatiently. But the guard was helping an old lady onto the platform, but Duck didn't realise this. "I can't wait any longer, we need to keep the time," he fumed. Suddenly, in the crowd, a young child had brought a guard's whistle with him on his journey and started blowing it. The ticket inspectors quickly scampered onto the coaches and Duck was relieved. "Hurrah, we're off at last," he said triumphantly, but the guard was still on the platform. "Stop," he shouted, but he was being careless. Just as the train started, he jumped on one of the coaches. The driver saw this and Duck came to a halt just beyond the platform. "What's the matter now?" he said furiously. "The guards just jumped on the train," explained the driver. "I'll give him a good talking to." The driver and fireman both explained to the guard that jumping on the train while it was moving was dangerous, and that they and Duck were very cross. The guard understood and explained to them about the child, but he also promised not to do it again. Duck was very sorry about it. He chaffed along his branch line to the junction where Thomas was waiting. "Oh dear, lazy bones," said Thomas. "Oh, what's that? Leaving the guard behind, are we? Ah well, you can't be an expert at everything, Duck." "Bah!" snorted Duck, but Thomas had already ran off laughing. Thank you.